After a couple of months, various information came, and my application for a county grant came, and I was going to get £180 a year, but I think plus the fees, I think they paid the fees, but £180 had to cover all my living expenses and things. Also, the great list of what I was to take with me to Cambridge arrived and slightly startled my mother. And this obviously went back to before the war, in the days when life was life. And it said I had to take 3 tablecloths and 4 dinner napkins and a great deal of that. And of course, before the war, quite a few of one's meals were actually eaten in the room. You had food sent up from the college kitchen. And and ate in those rooms, and we edited that slightly, but there was the demand for sheets and that. Now, my family, I can't pretend we were poor, but we certainly were only reasonably well off. And, you know, the sudden demand that I had to take 4 new sheets should be obtained was, you know, slightly through Mama and her housekeeping calculations. And she borrowed some sheets from her sister Dorothy, my aunt Dorothy, for instance. And then the dressing gown at home, I never used a dressing gown, but it said I was to have a dressing gown. So she very sweetly made me a dressing gown out of an army blanket, a grey army blanket. And she piped all the seams in purple, the royal colour, which is the King's College colour. And so with one thing and another, that was got together. At the very late stage, my poor father, who tended to leave things to mother, was suddenly thrown, because the college suddenly wrote and demanded what was called caution money, £40. Well, as my annual grant was £180, £40 was a fairly substantial sum of money in those days. And my poor father, who had left school, I suspect it was at 12 even, and had been his own man since then, was slightly startled to having to fork out for his son, you know, at the age of 18 and so forth. The caution money, £40, was a sort of deposit with the college against the possibility that I might do some damage. It was a down payment against any damage I might do. It was a very useful thing, because at the end of my undergraduate years, the caution money was paid, but it was paid to me, and I used it to go on holiday on the continent, but that's another story. And the day came and I went up, and I found that I had been allocated rooms in the Gibbs building, the great classical building with columns that stands opposite the gateway of King's College. Now, only 10 schoolboys went up to the college. The remaining 80 of the new arrivals were ex-servicemen. And these rooms in Gibbs building were large sets. They consisted of an enormous sitting room and 2 back rooms, which could be whatever. When I had a complete use of one of these sets when I was a don, I had the front room was my sitting room, and then one of the back rooms was my study, and the other one was my bedroom. But these were shared between 3. Now, simple arithmetic, I've said there were 10 of us schoolboys. And so, needless to say, the college divided us up into 3 groups of 3, plus the odd one. And very nicely, the social class matters in England were acknowledged. One of the groups of 3 came from Eton, Winchester and Rugby. One of them came from Marlborough, Christ College, Brecon, Shrewsbury. The third lot came from old established grammar schools at Wolverhampton, Manchester Grammar School, and there was a little Jewish refugee boy who'd been at a private school in Norfolk called Langley Park. And then there was poor old Letchworth Grammar School and me, all on my own. And what they'd done is they'd put me in with 2 ex-servicemen. Well, my visions of moving to Cambridge, having been brought up in a house that was full of people, because as well as the 4 children who still lived at home, my brother having gone off, we sometimes had lodgers during the war. And so I was the idea of having a place of my own was what I was dearly looking forward to. And to arrive in Cambridge and told that I had to share a set with 2 others, what is more, with 2 ex-servicemen, I was really, this was not what I was looking forward to. Fortunately, They were just as unsatisfied with having me in their company as I was with theirs. And they had a pal who had a room elsewhere in the college. And they put it to me, would I like to move into their friend's rooms so that he could join them in the set of three in the Gibbs building? Needless to say, I was extremely pleased to say yes. So I moved into his rooms. Now, his rooms were in a remote part of the college. And I say rooms, that was to say I had a sitting room and a bedroom in a very remote part of the college, which was called the drain. And it was damp and dark. And indeed, it was an early 19th century house that has sort of been incorporated into the college by a tunnel under a little road that called King's Lane, which ran down there. So to get to this place, you went down this passage, which of course was very damp, hence the name of the place, the drain. And we were a nice little company. It included such people as Peter Shaw, who later became a well-known Labour politician. It certainly was a bit damp. It has now been, of course, swept away, and some modern building has replaced it. But it was nice, and it was mine.